I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Portland CW. And yes, as we went into the last break, I did in fact refer to Portland's nocturnal nightlife. You did not imagine that. We're here with Kelly Clarke, arts and culture editor for Willamette Week. So we are, by my read, about 5 or 6, 7 weeks into the smoking ban in Portland.
Into the smoking ban, yes.
And it was a polarizing issue, to say the least. And I have gone to a couple bars around town, and somebody asked me what it was like. My wife actually asked me about my father's place, which is a bar slash restaurant that's on Grand, Southeast Grand. And she said, well, what was it like going in there after the smoking ban? And it was sort of like decaf, in that it seemed exactly the same in some ways, but you could sense that there was just something missing. And I don't know whether people will get used to that or whether it's going to have a long-term impact on their revenue. What's the general read from your vantage point?
You know, I have heard a lot of sort of people begrudgingly admitting that they're enjoying it. And this would be from the non-smokers who were against the ban, who were like, I like my club smoky, I like the atmosphere, and they're like, you know, I can deal with this because now I can breathe. And they seem to be enjoying it. As for the smokers, there is like a subset of bars in town that have started catering specifically to the outdoor smoker, sort of like the outdoor cancer fiend. And we actually did a story about it. They're basically pimping out their driveways, their backyards, their patios in order to make little smoking meccas.
The smoking lounge.
So there's actually a couple places that are a little bit more popular because they are sort of targeting smokers and being like, come here, come puff up in my patio. Eastburn, on Eastburnside, has actually embedded little mini fireplaces into tables on their patio. And they have porch swings that you can sit in. So it's basically like a child's playground, campground with cancer. Yeah, same thing with another roadside attraction, which is also in Southeast. They have a big booming campfire, and their bar was always kind of wooded. So it's basically like being, our writer described it as being on a Boy Scout trip with cancer.
I saw the most amazing,
which is kind of great,
chain of events at my father's place, where somebody came in and there was a conversation happening at the table, and half of the party were smokers, half of the party were non-smokers, and a discussion about the smoking ban ensued. And the non-smokers revealed that they hadn't really ever come in before because of the smoke, but now they were here. And the guy who was waiting on them overheard the conversation, and with sort of the most polite tone you could possibly imagine, went up and insisted that they order 3 times what they normally would because they were the reason that the smoking ban had been instituted, and that they were morally obligated to come in twice as often and buy twice as much and to spend their money.
Yeah, that's totally the way to get new customers. Really is, and keep them.
Really, it's just browbeating into loyalty.
Exactly. For me, I will still prefer my bar smoky. That's what I think of when I think of a bar, but it's something you're gonna have to deal with. The biggest problem, though, is that, as you said, middle of conversations, if people go out to smoke, now it's kind of like ladies going to the restroom. If one goes out to smoke, they all go out to smoke, and then half your party's out in the yard or in the patio, and you're drinking alone because you've just got you and your pint because everybody is out smoking. So in a lot of places, the bar's actually migrated outside now. So now
but it's, you'll have the satisfaction of mocking them someday when they're in an iron lung.
Exactly, which I look forward to.
All right, Kelly Clarke, arts and culture editor from the Willamette Week. So we will now end this by answering the question, who is Kelly Clarke? And we will answer that question through the following queries.
Bring it on.
Pen versus pencil.
Oh, pencil, number 2. Good graphite.
Really?
Sharp, has to be sharpened. This is just the way it is.
Waffles versus pancakes.
Always waffles, right, but the ones with the little holes, not the big Belgian ones, the butter monsters.
Waffles are like high-tech pancakes. That's why I like them.
Yes, yeah, they've got architecture.
Madonna versus Cyndi Lauper.
You know, I'm gonna have to go with Madonna just because she's a chameleon. So I know you like Cyndi Lauper. I've heard this already, but I'm sorry. You can't stare at me with laser eyes. It's not gonna change my answer.
Han Solo, Luke Skywalker.
Han Solo, please.
All right, excellent.
I wanted to marry him.
Snuggie versus Slanket.
I am a Snuggie girl. I own 2. Sometimes I wear them both at the same time.
That is fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
You should make that your Facebook status right now.
Kelly it actually
Clarke
already is.
Wearing 2 Snuggies as we speak. Kelly Clarke, the website is wweek.com.
It's wweek.com. Our Cheap Eats Guide comes out on March 11th. That's next Wednesday. Tons of cheap, great places to eat. And if you look in the paper, we pretty much got a cheap place every week for you to go gorge at.
Excellent. I'm Rick Emerson. Don't forget, if you find me even mildly amusing, you can hear me Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. on AM 970 The Talker. And if you've got a show idea, you can send it to us at outlookportland@yahoo.com. Outlookportland.com. Insert trademark catchphrase here. We'll see you next time on Outlook Portland, right here in Portland. See you later.